person who really had a seeking and got connected to me can never lose me. Understand? The fellows who ran away, either from the beginning they did not have seeking, they were only trying to encash on my powers. Will this power give that for me and this for me? It's a deal. For some people, I am only a yellow pages. ATM machine. Deal. And actually coming to me for a purpose, health or deal, not wrong. But after that, not becoming seeker is wrong.
Yes, sir. I fully agree.
Understand? Yes, sir. That's one. Second, there are some people who came with seeking, but in course of time lost the seeking. The intensity got lost. So, how to clean up all this mess? Whoever has just left did not abuse. When they leave the body, I'll appear and give them the darshan. If they connect back again, liberation. Because when they don't abuse, that disconnect, that umbilical cord will not be disconnected. But anybody abuse or actively listen to abusal, actively participated. Engada boinge na vandha paathu thanada avanum. Where will they go? They have to come and face me, na? Nobody is innocent, I am telling you. Nobody is innocent. Nobody is innocent. Everybody is intelligent enough to pick up case by case and study. Nobody is innocent. And there are some people who created and made others move out. They came back. Are you? I made a mess. And but these fellows who moved others out and they came back, these guys are brilliant, but they will have the karma of moving others out. That karma will go to them. That karma will go to them. How you know? In their life, two important people will leave them by somebody else spreading rumor about them. The same karma will come back. You understand? Lot of fun. Have fun. But people who have not abused will not have any karma. They just moved out and they don't know what is right and what is wrong, and what is good and what is bad. They just kept it with themselves. They will not have karma. They will not have the gurudroha karma. When they leave the body, because the umbilical cord is alive, I'll appear for them. I'll give them darshan. It seems some fools were trying to clean up my energy in the room. In the house, they brought Reiki healers and all and clean up the energy. First of all, my energy is too powerful. And it is too sensitive. You don't need anybody else to come and clean it up. Just say, we don't want you here, and simply I'll walk out. I am too sensitive, but too powerful. No Reiki healer can remove me. If I decide to sit. Understand? But I am too sensitive. You just say no, come on. Lot of drama. I just enjoyed day and night. I enjoyed. Laughing. Kala bhairu. I just saw the people entering into the mouth of the ignorance and being ground. Kalabhairava and Kali's Ganas having fun. This whole game, I look at the whole game spiritually. Poor fellows, many people who abused that time are feeling now they missed it. They could have just waited a little bit. they could have just had a little patience. They missed it. And especially when they are seeing now such visible powers are being demonstrated, they think, oh God, I always know he had a powers. Did I miss it? Did I make the decision too soon? It's like you diversed and that fellow suddenly got $1 billion lottery. After you diversed. I think I should have waited for 3 months. You understand? And that delusion was created such a way that everything is over. And I also just sat inside that cloud and laughing. You fellows, everything is over. Come on. Let's see. I also cooperated for the delusion to haunt people. It was Kalabhairava dimension of me. Enjoying the whole thing. Celebrating the whole thing. And the inauthenticity of the people and insensitivity of the people, I was enjoying. Inauthenticity and insensitivity of the people. It was actually feast for Kalabhairava. The remaining cleaning up and all was more like a people in course of, see, there will always be some people losing inspiration and dropping, that kind of the regular, that's all, nothing else. Nothing else. And it is this middle brokers played the game. You understand? Middle brokers. Hey, I am senior. What do you know more than me? I have been around more. I have been around so much. And this fellows and I was really having fun. Actually, it is a living in a body which is beyond the genders, and transcendental gender is a joy and freedom. The body which has no pain and no pleasure, which can neither be excited nor can be put in pain. It's a joy. It's too stupid game to lose. You understand? Too stupid scandal. In a lot of steps, I had fun. And it was so beautiful to see who has a inner strength and who is there. See, there was a time going to me was a fashion. There was a time condemning me was the fashion. So all these seasons. So who came to me because of society? Who came to me because of personal seeking? And who understands, who internalizes, all that. It's a nice game. And now there is a whole lot of a generation who don't even know what has happened. Right. That's a beautiful generation. Understand? But one thing, nobody was able to create controversy, is that he is a powerful being. Even the enemies were not able to. Even the fellows who had enmity were not able to make controversy out of that. They were able to create controversy out of right, wrong, good, bad. But he. Lot of fun. Lot of fun when everything comes to my attention and gets reported, the way I was reacting, responding, enjoying, celebrating. The biggest problem for the fellows who were trying to attack me was that I am not budging. Even one day I showed with myself with a morose face, they would have been happy. They would have been successful. They would have felt they are successful. That is not happening, is what is. You understand? They were going on crying. Oh, no, 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 inside is suffering, outside is acting. I told her, even if that is the case, how long I can act? Come on. At one day I have to show, na? Try your best. Let me see. Whether I am going to have the last laugh or you are going to have the last laugh, let's see. Actually, to tell you honestly, it is very unequal fight. How can you fight with God? End of the day. End of the day. That's what I said. Hey, after all, you fellows are human beings. Come on. It is like a end of the day unfair game. You understand? Not that unfairness was done to me. I am not telling in that way. Stupid fellows, human beings, did not know with whom they are fighting. It is like a, you are sitting and eating, having your dinner. Some small kids have picked up two, three spoons and fork and trying to kill you. They come shouting, I'll kill you, I'll kill you, run away, run away. And you sit and laugh, hey, what are you guys are doing? Now what they have planned and what they have done is beyond their capacity, but that is too small. That also has helped for us to know who is standing with us. And the war heroes. See this whole thing, how our guys have beautifully handled and held the whole thing together. And I did not even sit with them and instruct them how to do. They are so trained. And moreover, I only looked at it in this way, because I have to revive the whole Hinduism. What Hinduism is going through, I have to go through. Only then, now when I come out and win the game, I'll know the whole formula of bringing the Hinduism out of this whole war. So, that's the way I looked at the whole thing. I need a first-hand experience. First-hand experience. I can't afford to be innocently kind. I have to carry the kindness of Kala Bhairava. Understand? So, it actually matured my compassion and kindness. My compassion and kindness went through a powerful maturity. A weak withdrawal cannot be identified or named as a compassion or kindness. So, it was I had to personally go through this and win the game to bring the Hinduism out of this war and win the game for Hinduism. Krishna has to win the war to make Arjuna win the war. So he won the few wars first. Only then he was able to make the Arjuna win the war. So I think that's what I did. Because now I have to make the Sanatana Hindu Dharma, the Arjuna win the war. See, one day, I was just sitting in Samadhi and seeing, Aray, what is this? These fellows are making too much noise. And suddenly I saw Kala Bhairava just expressed himself and said, he said, don't worry, don't bother, just go and declare in the today's satsang, I am Kala Bhairava, I am Kali. And put that video into the public. Whoever gets offended by it will comment on it. That day morning satsang I came and said, I am Kala Bhairava, I am Kali, and put that YouTube. but in the website. Still that video is there in the website. At that time, when I told, even our ashramites were not ready to, they said, Swamiji, why to publish this in the media, in the YouTube, why don't you leave it? I said, do it. Now, after seeing the last 3 years history, you can understand, whoever made fun, whoever. Moral of the story is, even if you suspect somebody is enlightened, don't talk about them, keep quiet. That's the moral of the story. Even if you suspect, don't talk about them. Just shut all the holes and either you go and do good things and receive the benefit and enjoy, or just shut all the holes and keep distance. Go ahead.
Swamiji, I'm so confused with third eye process. Mm. I know that you can make all us read through third eye. Mm. And also, I believe I heard that you finished.
Why I am asking you to surrender, no. Not only opening it, now itself, I am making sure it becomes permanent.
Okay.
That is why this whole game is. Do one thing. I'll give you a simple straight technique. When you sit with a closed eyes to read, visualize your face is my face.
Yes.
Surrender all your feelings into me. Say, if Swamiji reads, it's glory for Swamiji. If Swamiji doesn't read, it's not glory for Swamiji.
Yes.
So I have nothing to do with this. Do you want to read or not? Read.
We'll be doing that.
Mm.
But again, I believe you said, doesn't matter how much you struggle, you cannot do it. I must do it. So
that is what I'm doing here.
Okay.
I'm asking you not to struggle. You put it on me, I'll do it.
Okay. I'll report tomorrow if you did.
All right, you test the power of my words. I'll do it.